now that we are familiar with gradients, let's actually use this concept and minimize the loss function of logistic regression. So yeah, just to recap, this is again the computation graph for logistic regression. And on the right-hand side, we can see the loss gradient, which consists of these two partial derivatives with respect to the model parameters that we want to update. And we can think of this partial derivative of the loss with respect to one of the weights as the slope of this loss function at a given point. And we can then use this concept for the so-called gradient descent algorithm to minimize the loss. So let's take a look at how this works. So gradient descent is an iterative process. So how does this work? So first we have this for loop here, which is iterating over the training epochs. Recall, a training epoch is essentially one iteration over the training set, and usually we need multiple training epochs to minimize the loss. So in each training epoch, we start with a placeholder value L equals 0. So that's our overall loss, which we set to 0 here as a placeholder. And then we iterate through the training examples. So for each training example, we compute this activation value, which we call the output, and then we compute the loss of this current training example using the loss function between this output value and the actual class label. And this loss value for this training example, we add this to the overall loss. So what we are doing here is we are actually summing the overall loss by iterating over the training examples. So once we iterated over each training example and computed the overall loss by summing the individual losses, we then normalize the overall loss. So we normalize the overall loss by dividing by n, where n here is the size of our training set. So n is the number of examples that we encounter in each training epoch. So this normalization term is not necessary, as we mentioned before, but it is nice to bring the loss onto a reasonable scale, so and it will make certain comparisons easier later on. So everything up to this point was about computing the overall loss. We can then use this loss to compute the gradient of this loss with respect to the model parameters W and B. And once we have these gradients, we use these gradients to update the model parameters. So this is very similar to what we did with a perceptron before, but for the perceptron, we had this error that we used for updating the weights. Now we use the gradient of the loss to update the weights. And how we do this is by multiplying the gradient with alpha, where alpha is the so-called learning rate. It's essentially just a small value that scales the loss so that our updates are not too large, because large updates might disturb the training. Alpha is essentially a so-called hyperparameter, and we will learn later how we can tune hyperparameters so that we can find the right value for alpha. For now, just consider what we are doing here is adding a scaled version of this gradient to the weight to update it. And we do the same thing here for the bias unit. So in the next video, we will learn about a variant of this algorithm called stochastic gradient descent. One thing I want to highlight though here is that gradient descent computes the loss over the whole training epoch. It's worth noting, and you will see later why. The other thing here worth noting is because the loss is based on the whole training epoch, the parameter updates are also based on the whole training epoch. So keep this in mind and then stay tuned for the next video on stochastic gradient descent.